We're going to simplify, and we've got what's called a quotient rule. Ultimately, what happens when you're dividing, you want to subtract the exponents. Whenever you look up, like you Google or you look in your textbook for the official rule, it looks like this, and they take the exponent in the numerator and subtract the exponent in the denominator. But really, it can also be this. The question becomes, should you have the leftover in the top or should you have the leftover in the bottom? Using the rule, yes, I am going to subtract 6 and 4. But 6 is bigger, so since 6 is bigger, the leftover is going to be in the top. In this next one right here, 2 and 5, I am going to subtract 5 and 2, but 5 is bigger, so the leftover is going to be in the bottom. So I'll show you what that means. Okay, so I have equals, and then 6 minus 4, and 6 minus 4 is y to the second power. But y to the second power technically is over 1. See how the answer is in the numerator? Now this one, there's a bigger number in the bottom. So I am going to subtract the 5 and 2, which is going to give me 3. But my x to the third is in the bottom rather than having it in the top because there was more there. The fallback plan besides using the rule is you can expand. And I hope that eventually you don't have to expand, but if you get stuck, it's a pretty straightforward way to get to your answer. If I have y to the sixth, I'm writing y times y times y times y times y times y. And y to the fourth is y times y times y times y. You start crossing off the things that are the same. So I can cross off these y's, just all these duplicates. Keep going here. Takes a little bit of time. And notice the extras are in the top. And so my answer for this one is y to the second power. I'm not going to write this out on all my other examples, but I'm going to do just one more. If we use our fallback plan, then this x to the second is x times x, x to the fifth, x times x times x times x times x. Then we start canceling. So this x cancels that one, this x cancels this one, and we don't have anything left in the top, but we know there's always a one there. So this is 1 over x to the 1, 2, 3. So 1 over x to the third power. Sometimes if you just visualize it expanding, when you go to subtract your exponents, you're like, oh yeah, there would be extra x's in the bottom. So the extra ones are there. Here, there's extra y's in the top. So my answer has the y's in the top. Okay, so let's just do a couple more just really quickly. This one here, I don't see the exponent on a, but it is to the first power. So I'm gonna be taking 5 minus 1. And when I take the 5 minus 1, the extra a's are on the bottom. So I'm gonna have 1 over 5 minus 1. So I have 1 over a to the fourth. In this one, the 3 is bigger. So when I take 3 minus 2, the extra a's are in the top. So I'm gonna end up with a to the first power. But anything to the first power is just itself. So that one is just a. Okay, showing even less work here. 10 and 6. There's more m's in the bottom. So 10 minus 6 is 4, so my leftover, my m is to the fourth in the bottom, so I have a 1 here. This one I have more g's in the bottom, So I'm gonna do 5 minus 2, which is 3, but the g to the third is gonna be here in the bottom, and all I have is a 1 there. This one, 7 and the 2, 7 is bigger. So when I do 7 minus 2, I have 5, but there's extra c's in the top. So this is c to the fifth. I could put this over 1, but like we talked about, dividing by 1 is the original. So it's just c to the fifth. Here, 8 and 3, 8 minus 3 is 5. There's more f's in the top. So this is f to the fifth there in the numerator.